Hello everyone. This demo will cover how to activate Amazon GuardDuty ECS Runtime Monitoring for instances running on Fargate. This protection plan extends your runtime threat detection to Amazon Elastic Container Service, Amazon ECS, workloads running on Amazon Elastic Compute Cloud, EC2, instances, and on AWS Fargate. GuardDuty is a threat detection service that protects your AWS accounts, workloads, and data by continuously monitoring AWS log and networking activity to identify malicious behavior using machine learning, anomaly detection, and AWS-developed and industry-leading third-party threat intelligence. Amazon ECS is a fully managed container orchestration service that helps customers more efficiently deploy, manage, and scale containerized applications. GuardDuty supports ECS deployments running on Amazon EC2 as well as Fargate. Amazon EC2 delivers secure, reliable, high-performance, and cost-effective compute infrastructure. AWS Fargate is a serverless compute engine for containers that works with Amazon ECS and Amazon Elastic Kubernetes EKS. Amazon ECS is secure by design, with resource isolation and native integration with AWS security, identity management, and governance tools. However, like any compute workload, container applications can run potentially vulnerable software or be misconfigured, leaving them susceptible to attack. GuardDuty ECS Runtime Monitoring deploys a lightweight, fully managed security agent that analyzes operating system level behavior, such as file access, process execution, and network connections. GuardDuty combines the newly added runtime visibility with existing control plane and network visibility to help customers identify and respond to threats targeting applications and data running in containerized workloads. GuardDuty ECS Runtime Monitoring allows security and application teams to uniquely detect sophisticated attacks that can occur across containers, underlying compute resources, and more broadly throughout a containerized environment. A modern security event could start with a compromise of a single container running a vulnerable web application with access permissions to underlying compute or Amazon ECS task resources, where misconfigured credentials could allow for broader access to the account and ultimately the valuable data stored within it. GuardDuty ECS Runtime Monitoring can be enabled with a few clicks in the GuardDuty console, leveraging AWS Organizations for multi-account management and ECS for automated resource discovery and agent deployment. Now, let's switch to the console for a brief demonstration. Runtime monitoring can be enabled for a standalone account or be enabled to monitor multiple accounts within your environment. To start off, we are going to enable runtime monitoring for a standalone account. So we've navigated to the GuardDuty console and selected runtime monitoring within the left-hand navigation panel. If we go under the configuration tab and scroll down, you'll have choices to enable runtime monitoring. First, we will select runtime monitoring, and this will enable runtime monitoring for this account. Select confirm. And now that that is enabled, as we can see from the banner above, we want to enable ECS runtime monitoring specifically. So if you also were interested in enable Amazon EKS runtime, you can enable that here. But for this demonstration, we are only enabling AWS Fargate for ECS only runtime configuration, and we'll simply select enable and confirm that we do want to have the automated agent configuration for AWS Fargate ECS only for this account. And now runtime monitoring has been enabled. Now let's go over how to enable runtime monitoring for multiple account environments. So we're still in the GuardDuty console. We're underneath the runtime monitoring protection plan, but this time we have logged into the delegated administrator account for an organization. So in a multiple account environment, only the GuardDuty delegated administrator account can enable or disable runtime monitoring for member accounts. So as we scroll down under runtime monitoring configuration, we see that we have a few more options. So let's select edit So the first step is to enable runtime monitoring, and you have two options. We can see that configure accounts manually has been pre-selected. And so this is in case you would only want to enable runtime monitoring for very selective accounts within your organizational unit, such as your delegated administrator account, which you can easily decide to only enable or disable runtime monitoring for that account. You can also decide whether or not you want to automatically enable runtime monitoring for new member accounts. This would mean that all member accounts that are added to this specific organizational unit will automatically have runtime monitoring enabled. You also have the option to enable for all accounts. And so all accounts that currently have GuardDuty activated and are in your organization, they will automatically have runtime monitoring enabled, and all future member accounts will have it automatically enabled as well. We are going to select enable for all accounts for this demo. Then we want to scroll down to the automated agent configuration for AWS Fargate. So you see that you have these same options as you did above, giving you the ability to either configure the automated agent configuration for very selective accounts within your organizational unit, or automatically enable for all accounts. In order to have full coverage and not have to worry about whether or not new accounts have the automated agent configuration enabled, we're going to enable for all accounts for this demo and then select save. Now that you have runtime monitoring enabled for Amazon ECS, you can navigate to runtime coverage. And underneath ECS cluster runtime coverage, you have the ability to see the coverage statistics for your AWS Fargate resources that are associated with your own accounts or your member accounts, and it shows the percentage of healthy Amazon ECS clusters over all of the Amazon ECS clusters in the selected region. Now that we have GuardDuty runtime monitoring enabled for AWS Fargate, let's look at a few findings. So I've navigated to the findings section within the GuardDuty console, and here under resource type, I've already filtered for the ECS clusters. And as we scroll down, we can take a look at this cryptocurrency finding. So we select the finding, we are going to be provided with a bit more context. So you have your overview information about the region, severity, but as we scroll down, we can also see some ECS cluster details. So you have the task ID as well as the specific name of the ECS cluster. You also have the specific container. So this is going to help when your task has multiple containers associated with it to really pinpoint which container. You also have information on the tags as well as action. As you scroll down a bit more, you also see under runtime details, you have process level information. So this is going to give you the executable path. You also have the hash associated with this finding. So this is something that you can run against known virus or malware databases. And you also have the ability to see all lineage. And that's just going to provide you a bit more information on how this threat got into your container. Now, if we switch over and let's look at this execution runtime reverse shell, this is another finding. You're going to have the same information given, but if we scroll down to that process level information that we've been provided, now you have the name of the binary and the associated executable path. And you can also see the lineage, and here we have three different levels, thus providing you with more information on how this finding came to be. We can select level 3, which is the earliest line of lineage. We can see we have the start time, namespace process, as well as the executable path. When we go to level 2, we can see that there was a bash associated with the finding. And level 1, you have the binary file. So all of this information that you're given on the GuardDuty runtime monitoring findings related to ECS clusters is going to allow you to respond faster and with a lot more precision to threats detected within your account. In this video, we demonstrated the GuardDuty runtime protection for ECS feature to teach you how to expand your runtime threat detection for ECS workloads running on EC2 instances and on AWS Fargate. For more information and to try GuardDuty ECS runtime monitoring at no cost for 30 days, please visit www.aws.amazon.com/GuardDuty.